movement going on in the financial services industry. And right now, let's switch gears and get back to the aviation industry. In fact, after Jet Airways and Kingfisher, SpiceJet has decided to go ahead and hike the fuel surcharge. This is a little counterintuitive because the airline industry is suffering. The seats aren't getting filled up. And how will consumers take a further increase in fares? My colleague Anisha Nair Dhawan has this report.
Even though crude oil prices have come off their peak last year, the recent hike in ATF prices has forced airlines like Kingfisher and Jet to increase the fuel surcharge by 250 to 300 rupees. Low-cost carriers like SpiceJet may decide to follow suit soon.
It is not a fair increase. I think there is an increase in the fuel surcharge by about 200 to 300 rupees, and we are still evaluating it. We think we will follow. It makes sense. The fuel has gone up by almost 15% in the last 1 month.
It's a tough decision for most airlines, as passenger load on most flights fell almost 10% last month. However, with airlines still not recovering cost, fare hike now seems inevitable. Some seats will still be available cheap to early birds under the Apex fare scheme. And for those who can postpone their travel, monsoon months may see a fall in airfares.
Demand will continue to be subdued, and my expectations, in spite of the top line fares that change, the overall fare to the customer would remain relatively stable. We are post quarter one hitting the worst off season that industry faces, which is July, August, September, and that I expect the fares to come down in quarter two.
Higher air ticket prices put a downward pressure on the load factor, which in any case has been falling thanks to the economic slowdown. Caught between a rock and a hard place, the airlines will have to bear more pain in the months to come. In New Delhi, Anisha Nair Dhawan for NDTV Profit.